Hey guys, this is Unseen Chaos. Here to show you another one of my roster members' abilities and moves and how you can use them in a fight. Today we're gonna work on Enzo. As you can see, he's not a full 3-star, but he is a 3-star, he's just not full. I got him on a good little pull. As you can see, his health though, as a showboat, is gonna be one of the most highest. All showboat classes, again, have the highest health. His moves are pretty explainable. He has almost 19,000 with his finisher. He destroys 5 random heal gems. His standing drop kick produces 4 heal gems on the board. And his diving DDT makes black into yellow. With my trainers that I have on board, this finisher does officially 8, destroys 8 kill gems on the board, and his standing drop kick creates 6. So you can see I get those bonuses. These guys are not very high. If they were higher, I'd be doing a little bit more. But for the meantime, they're real convenient. I don't need a whole lot. Again, when you're doing these guys, remember something to keep always in mind is their eras. He's from modern era, and their links. So Enzo and Big Cass are the best to work together. They generate heal gems, which will create more heal gems, 3 more. In modern era, gems do 5% extra damage. Now, before Enzo was fired from WWE, he actually had the Raw link too, that he could link up with anybody in Raw, and he could get those move points, if I'm not mistaken. We'll go in here and find out. Availables, hit Enzo, replace, and then links. Seems modern, they took out the Raw, which is crazy because the Raw link was really, really good. So we just go with modern. Out of this real quick. Now with Enzo, he's a good farmer. So with him, what you want to try to do is get as much loot crates as possible, and bust the loot crates so you can get more notoriety at the end of the match. But you don't want to overlook the fact that you're getting your butt kicked, right? You don't want to fall into too bad of a hole that you can't pull out of. These guys, especially Seth, will cascade on you. Cascade means they'll get multiple breaks. You don't want that happening to you. Alright, so we're kind of in a set reel here. So main thing is, if you can't find a move for yourself, keep your opponent away from his moves. So really, we're both good at New Houston. And I mean, the computer does the same to you on the same end. Keeps you away from your moves. Okay. We're gonna get the blue. Don't stop, nigga. We ain't done. Gonna do your fucking roadblock. 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 Let's see what happens. Oh, he got his blue off. I'll have mine next round. And he went straight for my yellow. Look at that. What a weasel. With this move, I'm going to put yellow on the board. I think it was 5. Let me make sure. Yep, 5. Alright. So here you have a choice. I know you see that. My second move is lighting up and it's ready to go. But I don't want to use it. I know he's probably going to get his finisher in his next move, but I'm going to take a chance, and I'm going to break these so I can have, at least I know for sure, one box. Hey, look at that. He didn't even get his, but I didn't get mine. And I kind of want to play a little bit, because like I said, this is a good farmer. So I want him to farm the board for me with these loot crates. I want to pick up my notoriety. Ah, 6,000. That's nothing. Awesome. Now I got 5 more loot crates on the board. Instead of the 2 or 3 that I had earlier. I said perfect farmer for all this. And you gotta know your opponent, and you gotta know your limits of what you're farming at. So this, it really doesn't matter. I'll take that perk just so I can get a little bit extra more damage. So there's no way he's gonna kick out of this. Now we go from 4 to 9. I heal all the way back up. My chain gang John Cena is healed all the way up. I get all my notoriety. And well, that's the way the cookie crumbles. I didn't get everything, but I got 2. So that's awesome. Again, it's just about knowing your opponent and what they can do, and knowing your limits and how far you can be pushed. I mean, obviously, I took a pretty weak match there to show you that, but I'm just showing you how farming with Enzo is unbelievable, because you can do this not only with, you know, versus, but you can do this in Gauntlet, you can do this in the events, you can do this in dailies, you can do this all day and get your 3 boxes loose. So, I mean, I highly recommend, if you have him, to try to use him and utilize him as much as possible, because he is great for just picking up extra stuff. So, but yeah, look at that. All right, get a couple of rewards here, or just one, I guess. Go and open it up so I can show you what it looks like. And it's just a prop box. It's gonna give me my prop parts. These are useful in feuds and blitzes. And you have your own little thing for posters, tokens, and props. I exalted a lot of my props about 3 feuds ago, so I'm really bare minimum. I'm restocking, as you can see. So, and then look, check it out, Shane O'Max payback came in. It's 29 of 30, so tomorrow I'll get a payday bag, and I'll get a chance at a 3-star token, which it's a guaranteed 3-star token. And the best thing about this is when you first pay for the payback, it gives you in 30 days Paul Orndorff. He's the only person you pay for in the game. The only person. Everybody else can be acquired by a pool. So you got a chance to pull anybody at any time. Especially in the mega pool, especially getting cash up here. I mean, you know, don't take it that everybody's saying, oh, these guys are free plays. Or, you know, the free play guys, everybody's free, honestly. Now your starters are Rock and John Cena, but everybody you can eventually win, or you can pull. But with that, if you like this video, drop me a like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Have a good night.